ISUPK.
Yo, I thought with a bumble clock to them boy, man. Bad mind never kill them. Suffocate on a pussy wall. Yo, status. Tell some boys we don't chat us.
Anyway, my dog go in on the street, them bad. Gun talking up with jeans, member. If any somebody ever treat them bad, send the pussy them, but meet them God. Louis me kicks upon me feet, them bad. Catch a new drip, dogs me beat them bad. Look how we just come and we a beat them bad. You know, sister, we is them dad. Hey, but anyway though, this a no playground. The Glock 19, they have to stay round. Nah, take no check with me payroll. Anything rise up, lay down. Them a send check, but they won't. Dog, we will make it step if they don't. But at the same old, said them want smoke, but the grab a done flame out. A couple of y'all a come through.
And one of the laws that needs to be kept is the dietary law. That law is going to show you the things what you're supposed to eat and the things what you are not supposed to eat according to God.
Right.
Christian church is not going to tell you that.
That's right.
Christian church is going to make you what? Tell you all things are good to eat.
That's
once
right.
They can get your goddamn money out of your pocket to drive Rolls Royce and Benz and all the latest transport that will happen in the goddamn world. But if they have to teach you the laws, you will stop sinning against our Most High power. Go ahead,
please. That's right.
The book of Leviticus 11 and verse 1.
Go ahead.
And the Lord spake unto Moses and to Aaron, saying unto them, speak unto the children of Israel.
And the Lord spoke unto Moses, telling Moses what? Speak unto the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, and let them know this.
Read, saying, these are the beasts which ye shall eat amongst all the beasts that are on the earth.
So the Most High is letting all blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians know that out of all the beasts that are on the face of the earth, this is what you are supposed to eat. Go ahead, read.
Whatsoever parted the hoof,
whatsoever parted the hoof, go ahead.
And is cloven footed.
And is cloven footed. Like the goat, like the sheep, like the deer. Go ahead.
And cheweth the cud.
And cheweth the cud. It must have the combination of chewing the cud and be cloven footed.
Right.
Read.
Among the beasts that shall ye eat.
Among all the beasts that is in the face of the earth, that is what you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians should be eating. Go ahead.
Nevertheless, these shall ye not eat.
And he's also letting you know, these are the things that you should not be eating. Go ahead.
Of them that chew the cud.
Of them that chew the cud.
Or of them that divide the hoof.
And of them that divide not the hoof. Like the goddamn horse. Like the donkey, now not to your horse. Going up for length anymore. The Most High is letting you know, horse is not good to eat. Read.
As the camel,
word.
Because he cheweth the cud,
word.
But divided not the hoof.
Because these beasts that the Most High tell you cannot eat, only choose the cut. They do not divide the hoof. These animals are what, boy, read.
He is unclean unto you.
The Most High is letting you know, so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, these beasts of the field are unclean to you.
That's right.
And if you take heed to the Most High God, Lord's commandments and statutes, we're going to understand that we will not end up in the hospital.
That's
we will
right.
not be suffering from high blood pressure.
That's right.
We will not be suffering from cholesterol.
That's right.
We will be not suffering from sickle cell.
That's right.
And all these other diseases.
Right.
It's time for you to understand that the God that we serve gave us laws to keep us in good health and order.
Right.
But when we disobey God, we do what? We end up getting prostate cancer.
Right.
And all these other goddamn negative diseases upon us, and we have to run to the hospital. And you know what? The doctor is going to tell you, hey, Mr. Sam, do you eat this? You need to stop eating this, Mr. Sam. You're going to get sick.
You need to stop doing that, Mr. Sam. You're gonna get sick. We have to understand, man, that God give us our dietary law in this scripture.
Right.
Our women will not be having what? Polycystic ovaries. So they wouldn't have to be running to the goddamn gynecologist and the doctor to see if they can make kids.
Right.
It's time for us to wake up and understand what power we serve.
Quite right.
And the warning, because he cheweth the cud, right, but divided not the hoof. And the corn, which is a goddamn rabbit, because he cheweth not the cud and divided not the hoof. Rabbit meat is not good to eat.
Right.
And the groceries is falling off of rabbit meat. You know why? Because Christmas is around the corner and they're trying to push all these things on you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians.
That's right.
So why? When you consume it, you'll be running to the hospital.
That's right.
Running to the Dr. Raj for goddamn Viagra. Because you have low sperm count.
That's
and
right.
All these negative things.
That's
stop
right.
Eating these goddamn things, man. And follow the laws that the most size put in this book for you. Go ahead, read verse 3. You need to understand, black man, black woman, Hispanic man, Hispanic woman, this book has our law in it, has all our laws in it, especially our dietary law. And if you follow these laws, you will not be going to the hospital. You will not be getting sick. You will not be getting high cholesterol. You will not be getting cataract and all these diseases. Because we follow the children of our goddamn oppressors. I want to go and eat, want to go and keep, we call this thing again, Curry Duck Festival. And all these goddamn nastiness. When duck also is not good to eat, read.
That's right.
And the swine.
And the what?
And the swine.
And the what?
And the swine.
And the goddamn swine that we like to put in our soups. That we love to go and get barbecue pigtails.
The Mosa is letting you know what?
And the swine.
And the swine. The goddamn pig. Read.
Though he divided the hoof.
Though he divided the hoof.
Wait.
And cloven-footed.
And he be cloven-footed.
Yet he cheweth not the cud.
The pig does not chew the cud. Read.
He is unclean unto you.
The pig, the swine, is unclean to you, black man.
That's
the swine is unclean to you, Hispanic woman. The swine is unclean to you, Native Indian woman.
That's right.
These things, when we consume them, guess what happens? They make us sick. They give us arthritis and all these negative diseases. Our Christian pastors is not going to teach us these things. They want to get you in their goddamn churches to give them their money so they can live in big houses and drive nice cars and send their kids to the best school in the goddamn country. But the Most High, the creator of heaven and earth, in all his goddamn wisdom, is letting you know what? These things is nothing. He's letting you know what? These things are not food.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat.
The Most High is reiterating it again.
Of their flesh you shall not eat.
Wait.
And their carcass.
And their what?
And their carcass.
Wait.
Shall ye not touch.
And their carcass you shall not touch.
Don't go and get barbecue pigs here. And go to the meat shop and get pigs here to put in your soup.
You understand?
There are other meats that the Most High have already prescribed for us to eat.
Verse 10.
Wait.
And all that have not fins and scales.
And guess what? The Most High also let us go in the waters. All that have not fins and scales.
Wait.
In the seas.
Wait.
And in the rivers.
All right, go ahead.
Of all that move in the waters and of any living thing which is in the waters, there shall be an abomination unto you.
The Most High said to us, know all that has not been scared in the waters, in the sea, in the rivers, all those that have not been scared, that combination, they are unclean to you. They will make you get sick. They'll make you go to the hospital. Guess what? Again, the Most High, in his infinite wisdom, is not going to put these creatures there for you to eat. Just like these animals in the forest die. They are creatures, they are other animals,
that will come to clean the forest.
The Most High ain't going to send you to the bottom of the ocean with a goddamn mop and a broom to clean the bottom of the ocean. These things are to clean the ocean. These things are to keep the ocean clean. And guess what? Because we follow our oppressors, because we follow the children of our oppressors, we do what? We go and eat what they eat. We follow what they follow. And the Most High God is letting you know, you are not supposed to do these things, man. You have to understand, man. Black man, Hispanic woman, crab, shrimp, lobster, and all these unclean things is not for you to consume. These things are not food. These things were not given us to us to eat by the Most High power. The Christian church is not going to let you know that. Our president is not going to let you know that. We're going to have a reason this. Keep the medical field and the medical industry pumping so you can get sick and they can make money off of you. Where are you? Yes. Right, black man, black woman, Hispanic man, Hispanic woman, you have to understand, we need to come back to the laws, commandments, and statutes of our God. We need to come back to the laws, commandments, and statutes of our Most High power to understand the things that we need to do to stop sinning against our power, to stop making the Most High bring these judgments upon us. Read. Because sentence against an evil word. Because what? Because sentence against an evil word. Because sentence against an evil word. That evil word is also when you throw crab, shrimp, and lobster. When you go against what the Most High tell you are supposed to eat. That is an evil word. Go ahead.
Is not executed speedily.
Because what? I can read that.
The book of Ecclesiastes 9 and 11.
What?
Because sentence against an evil work.
Because sentence against an evil work. What?
Is not executed speedily.
Is not executed as fast as you would like. What?
Therefore, the hearts of the sons of men.
Guess what? The hearts of the sons of men. Where
is fully set in them to do evil?
So because the Most High is not bringing that judgment upon you as quick as possible, our heart is continually set to do evil. You know what we say? Nah, that small thing. God will forgive me for that. Nah, we could eat crab, shrimp, and lobster. We go there. My grandmother eating crab, shrimp, and lobster from since 1962, and she ain't dead yet. But here what the scripture say, because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily. Our people, the hearts of our people is continually set to do evil. It's time for us to stop sin against the Most High God. It's time for us to stop sin against our power. Right?
The book of John, chapter 9 and 1.
Where?
And as Jesus passed by,
and as what?
As Jesus passed by,
what?
He saw a man.
He saw what?
A man.
What?
Which was blind from his birth.
So guess what? Jesus was walking by, and he saw a man that was blind from his birth. Guess what? When that man born, he was born blind.
And his disciples asked him.
And his what?
Disciples asked him.
And Christ's disciples said, Christ, go ahead, read.
Saying, Master, who then sinned?
So his disciples are saying, Christ, answer me this. Who did sin? Go ahead.
This man or his parents?
Did this man sin or his parents?
And his disciples asked him,
saying, what?
Master, who did sin?
Who did sin? When?
This man?
How could this man sin when he had just born? We have to ask ourselves this question. The Christian church ain't going to tell you that. When? Read.
Or his parents. That he was born blind?
When?
Jesus answered, neither hath this man sinned, nor his parents.
Guess what?
Christ did not deny the question that they had asked. Christ said what? Neither did this man sin or his parents. Guess what? We think that we can go along and eat four crab, shrimp and lobster and get away with it. Okay, granny eat four crab, shrimp and lobster. Since 1962, nothing happened to granny. Granny dead. But then granny had children, just like the blind man, just like the man who was born blind. Guess what? That sin is going to fall upon your goddamn children. If it ain't up to you, it's going to fall upon them.
That's right.
It's time for us to wake up and understand what power we're dealing with.
That's
what
right.
Power we're supposed to serve. And get out of the goddamn Christian church because they are telling you lies.
That's right.
Upon lies. Upon lies.
That's right.
We are the ISUPK coming out of 1 West, 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commanding General Leanna. And again, we are not affiliated with any Christian organization or group.
That's
and with
right.
That, I say shalom.
Going on the street, them bad. Gun talking and we change member. If any somebody ever treat them bad, send the pussy them but meet them God. Louis me kicks upon we feed them bad. Catch a new drip, dub the beat them bad. Look how we just come and we a beat them bad. You know sister we is them dad. Hey, but anyway though, this a no playground. The Glock 19, they have to stay round. Nah, take no check with me payroll. Anything rise up, play down. Them a send check, but they won't. Dog, we make it step if they don't. But at the same old, said them want smoke, but the grab a done flame out. A couple y'all a come through. Y'all a WhatsApp, what she gonna come to? She a give me tap and she swallow some juice. Y'all a suck cock till me Jonathan blow. Bentley van a come through. Convert to the drop top, still have a sunroof. The dog them rolls, chop your one proof. Alright, gonna move, gonna move. Anyway, my dogs go in the street, them bad. Gun talking and we change member. If any somebody ever treat them bad.